behalf of St. Peter's Lutheran Church in Holgate, Ohio, we welcome you to worship. I'm Pastor Julie Lehman Guy. If this is your first time worshiping with us, drop me a message and we'll make sure you're added to the notification list. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty God, the resplendent light of your truth shines from the mountaintop into our hearts. Transfigure us by your beloved Son, and illumine the world with your image. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from 2 Kings, the second chapter. Now when the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they went down to Bethel. The company of prophets who were in Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he said, "Yes, I know. Keep silent." Elijah said to him, "Elisha, stay here, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho." But he said, "As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they came to Jericho.
The company of prophets who were at Jericho drew near to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he answered, "Yes, I know. Be silent." Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me to the Jordan." But he said, "As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of prophets also went and stood at some distance from them as they were both were standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water. The water was parted on to the one side and to the other until the two of them crossed on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you." Elisha said, "Please let me inherit a double share of your spirit." He responded, "You have asked a hard thing, yet if you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted you. If not, it will not." As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them, and Elijah ascended in a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, "Father, Father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen." But when he could no longer see him, he grasped his own clothes and tore them in two pieces. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. Psalm 50, verses 1 through 6. The Mighty One, God the Lord, has spoken, calling the earth from the rising of the sun to its setting. Out of Zion, perfect in its glory, God shines forth in glory. Our God will come and will not keep silence, with a consuming flame before and round about a raging storm. God calls the heavens and the earth from above to witness the judgment of the people. Gather before me, my loyal followers, those who have made a covenant with me and sealed it with sacrifice. The heavens declare the righteousness of God's cause, for it is God who is judge. A reading from 2 Romans, the 4th chapter. Even if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. In their case, the God of this world has blinded the minds of the unbelievers to keep them from seeing the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God. For we do not proclaim ourselves, we proclaim Jesus Christ as Lord and ourselves as your slaves for Jesus' sake. For it is the God who said, "Let light shine out of darkness," who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the 9th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. 6 days later, Jesus took with him Peter and James and John and led them up a high mountain apart by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And there appeared to them Elijah with Moses, who were talking with Jesus. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Rabbi, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He did not know what to say, for they were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice, "This is my Son, the Beloved. Listen to him." Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Let us pray. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. We pray today, as we gather to worship you, that you would calm the voices that distract us, those voices that pull us away from you. Open our ears and our hearts that we may truly listen and hear your word for us. We pray this in Jesus' name, and together we say, Amen. Well, today we celebrate the transfiguration of our Lord. Let's dig a little deeper so we can understand what we're reading before we apply it to our lives. Our reading from Mark begins with the word 6 days later. Now, why is that information important? Well, perhaps it's a reference back to Moses in Exodus 24. It reads, "Then Moses went up on the mountain, and the cloud covered the mountain. The glory of the Lord settled on Mount Sinai, and the cloud covered it for 6 days. On the seventh day, he called out to Moses out of the cloud." Well, the 6 days might also be connected to the Festival of Booths. According to Leviticus chapter 23, we read, "Speak to the people of Israel, saying, on the 15th day of this seventh month, and lasting 7 days, there shall be the Festival of Booths to the Lord. Now the 15th day of the seventh month, when you've gathered in the produce of the land, you shall keep the Festival of the Lord lasting 7 days, a complete rest on the first day, and a complete rest on the eighth day." Now the Festival of Booths was also called Sukkot. It was a time set by God for the people to remember their ancestors in the wilderness. For 7 days, they lived in Sukkots, the temporary dwellings which farmers would live in during the harvest. Once again, it was a festival that would have been part of Jesus' life and traditions. Once again, Jewish tradition tells the story of their ancestors so that it will never be forgotten. Once again, Jesus references something familiar to make something new. And once again, our cast of characters is small: Jesus, Peter, James, and John. Now, these three have witnessed Jesus' healing of Jairus' daughter. These three will be selected to pray with Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane. These three have seen what rising from the dead looks like. From glory to agony, they will walk with Jesus. But for today, we focus on this moment, the transfiguration. According to the Merriam-Webster dictionary, transfiguration means to give a new and typically exalted spiritual appearance. In other words, a change that transcends the everyday expectations. Imagine being there that day. Imagine the moment you realize that Jesus is not alone. Perhaps you close your eyes and open them again. Imagine the brilliance. One morning this week, I looked out and there was sun shining on the glistening snow. It looked like someone had sprinkled glitter over the yards and the fields. The sun reflecting on the snow made it difficult to drive. It was so brilliant. But it was breathtaking too. So imagine the confusion that Jesus was alone and suddenly he is not. It might have taken a moment to realize that it was Elijah and Moses because they were long dead. And Mark tells us they were terrified. So Peter speaks up, offering to make a dwelling, because when we're afraid, we try to shift the focus. He wanted to fix the moment by giving them something they could focus on. And the response was not from Jesus, but from God. "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." These words reflect back to Jesus' baptism. But the difference is now the disciples hear God's proclamation. So the question for us today, what will it take for us to listen to Jesus? Well, on Monday, I was given a book by Pastor Michael Adam Beck entitled The 21st Century Christian Following Jesus Where Life Happens. In the book, discipleship is defined as learning and living out the way of Jesus in the world. They challenge that being a disciple is more than weekly worship and memorizing Bible verses, but rather how we walk, talk, and love. Discipleship requires community as we learn to do life together and respond to life's pressures. Well, in our reading today, Jesus has invited his three closest friends into the inner circle. Now remember, Jesus had 12 disciples that he taught, but these three received the confirmation of who Jesus was directly from God. Jesus invested time in each of his disciples, preparing them for the journey ahead, because Jesus knew what was to come. But Jesus also knew that these three would become leaders and encouragers. Not only was Jesus transfigured, Peter, James, and John were transformed by their experience with Jesus. What will it take for you to listen to Jesus? God has spoken. Listen. Well, this weekend we have our annual meeting. One of the topics is how we will care for our siblings who are not comfortable or who have not been able to gather. And it's going to require a commitment from each one of us. It's going to require a commitment of finances, a commitment of time to help with things like setting up tables and chairs or greeting or distributing the Lenten bags for those who are not out and about. And it's going to require a commitment of learning new ways of worshiping and growing as disciples together in community as our community is changing. And then next Wednesday, we will gather again in person to confess our sins and to be reminded of our mortality. And we know that some of our siblings will be missing from that gathering, and so we offer new ways for them to listen. What will it take for you to listen to Jesus? This year has been a year of challenges, but also new opportunities. So listen to Jesus. Give of yourself, your time, your talents, and your treasures so others may come and listen. Listen and let Jesus transform you. Amen.
The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and the arrow that flies by day. Though thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun. To the angels, God's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands, they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings.
Let us join together with the saints of every time and age, confessing our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. As we offer to God our tithes, our treasures, and our offerings, let us pray together. O God, receive these gifts as you receive us, like a mother receives her child with arms open wide. Nourish us anew in your tender care, and empower us in faithful service to tend to others with this same love. Through Jesus Christ, our saving grace. Amen.
Guided by Christ, made known to the nations, let us offer our prayers for the church, the world, and all people in need. For the gospel proclaimed in word and deed, for communities of faith far and near, and for all who show the face of Christ throughout the world, let us pray. Have mercy, O God. For creation, sun, moon, and stars, life forming in the dark earth and ocean deep, mountains, clouds and storms, and creatures seen and unseen, and for the Holy Spirit's guidance in our stewardship of God's creation, let us pray. Have mercy, O God. For those responsible for safety and protection, for emergency responders and security guards, attorneys and advocates, civil servants and leaders of governments, that they witness to mercy and justice throughout the world, let us pray. Have mercy, O God. For all who suffer this day, especially those suffering from COVID and those we name at this time, that Christ our healer transforms sickness into health, loneliness into companionship, bereavement into consolation, and suffering into peace, let us pray. Have mercy, O God. For companions on life's journey in this worshiping community, for loved ones who cannot be with us this day, and for guidance during struggles we face, that God's glory is revealed around and among us, let us pray. Have mercy, O God. In thanksgiving for the faithful departed who now rest from their earthly pilgrimage, that their lives of service and prayer inspire us in our living. Let us pray. Have mercy, O God. Merciful God, hear the prayers of your people, spoken or silent, for the sake of the one who dwells among us, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, we pray as Jesus taught. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray together. O God, you have called your servants to ventures of which we cannot see the ending, by paths as yet untrodden, through perils unknown. Give us faith to go out with good courage, not knowing where we go, but only that your hand is leading us and your love supporting us, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God the Creator, strengthen you. Jesus the Beloved, fill you. And the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, keep you in peace. Amen.
I love to tell the story.
Christ. Thanks be to God.